very warm welcome. You're watching the news with me, Anubhuti Gaur. Let's take a look at what's making headlines. All eyes on the opposition meet tomorrow afternoon to discuss the current political situation in the backdrop of student protests and the controversial citizenship law and the NRC. The meeting aimed at opposition unity will not be attended by Bengal Chief Minister Mamata Banerjee and BSP Chief Mayawati. Both Mayawati and Mamata Banerjee attacked the Congress party recently, and BJP has accused Congress of engineering protests across the country by spreading lies against the CAA and the NRC. Drawing fresh battle lines with the BJP, JDU Vice President and poll strategist Prashant Kishore took to Twitter today to declare that the Citizenship Amendment Act in the NRC will not be implemented in Bihar. He even went on to thank Congress's Rahul Gandhi and Priyanka Gandhi Vadra for their formal and unequivocal rejection of the CAA and the NRC. He wrote, "Both deserve special thanks for their efforts on this count." Ahead of the upcoming union budget, Nobel laureate Professor Abhijit Banerjee on Saturday said that he would not support fiscal tightening right now. Fiscal deficit had been breached by a huge margin already. Reacting to questions about the centre's plans to cut the education budget by approximately 3,000 crore, Banerjee said that it would not have much of an impact as education is a state subject. The union budget will be presented by Union Finance Minister Nirmala Sitharaman on 1st February 2020. PM Modi today inaugurated Kolkata Port Trust's 150th anniversary event, renamed Kolkata Port Trust as Dr. Shyam Prasad Mukherjee Port. West Bengal Chief Minister Mamata Banerjee skipped the event. While speaking on the controversial Citizenship Act at the Belud Mutt earlier, he said that the opposition is spreading rumours on the CAA and that the youth is being misled on the act. The government has made sure that the law does not impact anyone negatively. He also added that Pakistan has to answer why it committed atrocities on minorities for 70 years. The last of the four illegal multi-story apartment complexes in Mayadu town of Kerala's Kochi was successfully demolished in the final round of controlled implosion on Sunday. Golden Kayalorum, the 17-storey building with 40 flats, was the last to be razed for flouting coastal zone regulation norms as dust and fume from the rubble settled in the surrounding areas. The Supreme Court had ordered the demolition of these four flats with more than 350 houses in May last year. The outgoing Indian ambassador to the US, Harshvardhan Shringla, called on US President Donald Trump at the White House on Saturday and thanked him for his steadfast support for strengthening the India-US strategic partnership. Shringla is set to be the next Foreign Secretary of India ahead of his visit to New Delhi Ambassador Alice Wells. Acting Assistant Secretary of State for South and Central Asia described Shringla as a captain of India-US relationship. A Jammu and Kashmir police officer decorated with the President's Medal for Bravery was caught on Saturday with two terrorists travelling in a vehicle on the Srinagar-Jammu highway. The terrorists were on their way to Delhi, police sources said. Davinder Singh, Deputy Superintendent of Police posted at the sensitive Srinagar International Airport, was caught at Wanpur in Kulgam district with Hizbul Mujahideen terrorist Naveed Babu. That's all in this bulletin. Thanks for watching. The news and updates will continue on the other side. We'll be right back.